The electric flow starts from this point, which is its input, and this is its output. When the switching relay turns on, electricity flows to the outdoor unit through this black wire, while the brown wire carries power to the input side. Here, this relay is installed, and if there is a communication fault, it will keep switching repeatedly, turning on and off multiple times. This will happen about 5 to 6 times, and then the unit will shut down without displaying any error. This fuse is installed, and its value is 1.15 amps. This fuse will burn out whenever there is a fluctuation. Apart from this, there is no filtering system installed here. Only a capacitor has been added, which is used to control voltage spikes. Other than this capacitor, no additional filtering components are present. Additionally, a ZNR, zinc oxide varistor, is installed here, which acts as a protection device. If the voltage exceeds 250 volts, this ZNR will short circuit, causing the fuse to burn out. This process protects the next PCB from damage. After the ZNR, you can see that negative and positive wires are coming in. Here, this is the negative wire, and this is the positive wire. Notice that the positive wire goes through the NTC sensor, which is installed here. From this point onward, rectification begins. There are two diodes installed here for rectification, and another set of diodes is also used for the same purpose. Additionally, there is one more diode installed further along the circuit. The positive output from this rectification process is passed through a safety device to prevent backflow in case of any issue. This point represents the positive output, while this is the negative point. As you already know, after rectification, the AC voltage is converted into DC voltage. Once converted, the DC voltage reaches this point. However, there is also a capacitor installed here, which has a rating of 10 microfarads and 450 volts. There are two capacitors in this section, one in the front and one at the back. These two capacitors, together with the choke between them, form the EMI filter that helps reduce electromagnetic interference on the AC lines. The voltage across these two capacitors should be around 300 volts to 350 volts at both points. A switching IC has been used along with some resistors and capacitors. The switching IC used here is labeled Q100. I searched extensively in the market for this IC, but I couldn't find it. So I looked for a replacement and installed an alternative IC. Now let me explain the function of this IC in detail. Pin number 1 can be identified by this dot mark, which indicates the first pin. This pin is ground, GND, and it eventually connects to the drain. When this connection is established, the chopper transformer will turn on, allowing the circuit to function. Pin 2, VCC. This is the power supply pin. It requires a voltage between 5 volts to 9 volts for the IC to turn on. If there is no voltage at this pin, the switching IC will not activate and the PCB will remain non-functional. Pin 3, VFB. This is the feedback pin, which plays a crucial role in regulating the circuit. The feedback signal comes from the optocoupler, which is responsible for stabilizing the output voltage. The optocoupler receives its signal from the secondary side of the power supply, ensuring that the power delivered remains consistent and within safe limits. Once the optocoupler detects the correct voltage levels, it sends a signal back to the switching IC, informing it that the system is functioning correctly. What is feedback? Feedback is the process of monitoring and regulating the system's performance. When electricity flows through the chopper transformer, it creates a loop. This loop helps in generating the required output voltage, which is then monitored and sent back via the optocoupler. The optocoupler continuously turns on and off, sending a signal to the switching IC, confirming whether the system is operating correctly. This entire process is called feedback, and it is received at pin 3. Pin 4. This pin is not connected to anything. It remains empty. Now let's talk about the next pin, which is pin 5. This pin is responsible for voltage generation, and the voltage is directly generated here. Let me explain how this happens. How voltage is generated at VSTR pin 5? 100 kiloohms resistor is installed. This resistor is used to drop the voltage. The incoming voltage is 320 volts, which is coming from the positive side and is directly passing through this resistor. Due to this voltage drop, the 320 volts is reduced to 15 volts at this point. These 15 volts will be used further, and I will explain their role in a moment. The next three pins in this IC are all drain pins. Inside the IC, there is a built-in MOSFET, which will be switched on and off using these drain pins. When the drain pin is activated, it allows negative and positive voltage flow, completing the circuit. Once the circuit is complete, the chopper transformer turns on. The chopper converts high voltage into low voltage. When the chopper operates, it steps down the high voltage, 320 volts, into a lower DC voltage, which is then supplied to different components of the PCB. Now, let's check the voltages at different points. This makes troubleshooting and repairing much easier. This entire section is the SMPS system, and this is the switching IC. Over here, we have the feedback circuit responsible for regulating the power supply. Now, we will check all the voltages step by step. First, we apply electric power while ensuring correct positive and negative connections. As you can see, the PCB has now powered on. Now let's check the capacitors that I previously mentioned. Measuring the voltage across the capacitors, the first capacitor shows 312 volts, which is within the expected range. Checking the second capacitor, we should get the same voltage. As expected, the second capacitor also shows the same voltage. These voltage measurements confirm that the rectification process is working correctly, and the SMPS system is functioning properly up to this point. Now, let's check pin number 2, VCC. This pin can generate two types of voltages, depending on how we measure it. First, when measuring pin number 2 with negative GND as the reference, we should get around 10 volts. Upon checking, the reading shows 10.63 volts, which confirms that the voltage is correct. Next, when measuring pin number 2 relative to the drain pin, we should get around 310 volts. Upon testing, it shows 316 volts, which indicates that this pin is also connected to the chopper transformer. Additionally, there is a diode installed in this section. Checking its voltage, we find that it measures 328 volts at one point, and when measured at another location, it shows 10 volts. These voltage readings confirm that the circuit is functioning as expected. Now let's check pin number 3, which is the feedback pin. As previously explained, feedback is generated through the optocoupler. There is also a capacitor connected to this pin, along with its respective line. Now, checking the voltage at this point, we can see that it fluctuates around 0.597 volts. This is normal because the expected range for proper feedback operation is between 0.5 volts to 2.5 volts. If the voltage falls below this range, the circuit will not function correctly. Next, let's check pin number 5, VSTR, where voltage is supplied through a 100 kiloohms resistor. Upon testing, we can see that the voltage at this point is 320 volts, which confirms that the circuit is functioning correctly. This voltage is essential because it is what turns on the IC. Now, let's move on to the low side of the circuit to check how it is functioning. As I previously showed you the capacitors on this side, let's check them again in detail. The key capacitors here are C207, C208, and C210. These capacitors should have the correct voltages because if the readings are accurate, then the rest of the system should function properly. Checking capacitor C207, the voltage reading is 5 volts, which is correct. Checking capacitor C210, this capacitor also shows 5 volts, confirming that it is working fine. Checking capacitor C208, here, the voltage reading is 12 volts, which is also correct. Since all these capacitors have the expected voltage levels, this indicates that the circuit is functioning properly. This method of voltage checking helps in quickly diagnosing and repairing the PCB efficiently. Click on the left or right thumbnail to watch our next videos and subscribe. Thank you.